This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Relief Windows. Visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to Paradise, Louisiana. Bedroom Boudin and Cajun meet again this week. And we got a full-up show. That's all I can tell you. We got fishing report, Abu Garza fishing report. We're going to make a trip to the Nature Conservancy, the center that's in the Chaffalai Spillway. And it's going to be good right now because the fish are starting to bite in the spillway. We got good saccalator reports. The water's finally falling again. So we got a great fishing report. We're going to make a trip back again to the Duck Festival, but it's all about specklebelly goose calling. So just stay tuned. We got a busy week. Like I said, we got a few duck reports. We got one deer picture. Stay tuned. Bad Wrongs, Blue Dan, Cajun meat, Port Allen, Louisiana.
Asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did, so I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with four electrolytes lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4, the complete sports drink.
It's been about 10 years since we started launching our Chaffalaya project out here, and this is not the end. This is kind of an important milestone for us, but this is going to allow us to do even more as we go forward out here.
With the opening of a Chaffalaya Conservation Center, we will host university partners, community stakeholders, teachers, students, and others who are all part of this work, helping us to measure the impacts of conservation and restoration on the basin, helping us tell the story and ensure the health of the basin for future generations.
But why are we here? We're here because we're working to make sure that we save the Atchafalaya Basin. When I say save it, I mean save it, preserve it for generations to come. And there's a lot going on here. There's everything from energy activities to fisheries to much recreation. Through hunting trails, other things that people enjoy doing here.
You can go out there and you can see 500-year-old cypress trees. I have seen bald eagles, alligators. I don't think you can find anything more beautiful than this basin.
That's what they see in a little area, and then you remind them of how large it is and what a percentage of Louisiana, a significant percentage of Louisiana in the nation it is. It's just mind-blowing to folks, and they really are in awe.
And the Nature Conservancy has figured out a way to bring in everybody, from individual donors like us to big corporate donors, to public agencies, to work in cooperation with them. They really have got the formula, I think.
We want to fold this into the state's coastal program. We want everybody to recognize the importance that the basin plays in the whole coastal ecosystem.
This basin is 5 times more productive than any other river basin on this continent. 5 times more productive in terms of its ecology.
The Atchafalaya River Basin is pretty awesome. But just to be able to see it so distinctly in person, you can show that picture, and it looks photoshopped. But then when you see it in real life, it's just powerful.
We want this place to be a special place to many people for many reasons. And we want decision makers to show up here, and people from around the world to help us all understand how we can do better, help conserve the natural resources we have here in Louisiana.
To get the full effect of being on one of the great wildernesses of America, but it also be an eye-opening thing for the public and those decision makers to really appreciate the important work that's gonna happen here.
This is important. When you look at Louisiana, you look at the things we enjoy, we are sportsman's paradise. And we can't have sportsman's paradise without the ecological productivity that we all have enjoyed for so many generations. And this investment's going to allow us to get it right to make sure that we can enjoy it for generations more.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
There's no better way to cool down this summer than with a delicious, thirst-quenching Polar Pop Cup from Circle K. The Polar Pop Cup is the coolest way to beat the heat. Fill your Polar Pop Cup up with the flavors you crave and crushed or cubed ice. Nothing stays cold longer, so you can stay refreshed all day long. Stop in Circle K today for an ice-cold Polar Pop Cup. Polar Pop Cup, only at Circle K. Take it easy.
Original matrix shed in the lemon head color, just like we did on the last Dockside TV. That's a hard combination to beat. But what I'm throwing is our brand new mega matrix. It's a 4-inch and the green hornet. Looking for a few bigger fish. See if we can get some. Fish
Switch on, switch on. Oh, double up. Oh, and I missed mine. Nice fish. Again, Josh is throwing the original 3-inch matrix shad in the lemonhead color. Well, I'm throwing a little bit larger profile bait with the mega matrix. And where we're at today, a little bit different from the last episode. There he is. A little bit different. Oh, missing again. Come on now. Last episode, we were at Mid Lake, had a fallen tide, fishing in turbulent conditions. We were on the east side, fishing in pretty wavy conditions. Today, it's relatively calm. We got a nice incoming tide. We came all the way down to the south shore. And that's something you gotta do on the bridges all the time. It's just because you caught them someplace the day before, the week before, whatever. These fish really move around a lot. The wind dictates where they're gonna be. Boat pressure really dictates it. And today where we're finding them is all the way down on the south end. So you just gotta move around. We started off on the north end, didn't do much. Caught a few at Mid Lake, and we really got on a nice rhythm down here on the south end. Gotta move around and you get on a nice steady bite. I find an incoming tide, the south end usually is a little bit better. Rolling on that mega matrix. 3/8 ounce on that 4-aught hook. You gotta use that 3/8 to get that bait down to the bottom. You can feel these fish right now when I grab them. They're pretty cold. Water temperature 63 right now, and they're getting into their annual bridge pattern.
My wife and I started Relief Windows. What our goal was to give a quality job to a homeowner. Everybody's scared of contractors. We wanted to change the mold of what that is. The reason why you should pick Relief Windows to do your renovation of your home, windows, doors, hardy plank, or siding, is because of the experience, quality service of our company. We're gonna show up on time, we're gonna do the job right. The job's not done until you're happy and we're happy. We believe you deserve a quality job.
Hey, welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and this is our weekly hunting report. Most of it has been about ducks, but it's been a hit or miss. And I'm going to tell you, the big news is down in Burris with Ryan Lambert, very, very slow. My grandson and his friend, Matthew Venable and them, they killed 6 one day and 8 or 10 the next day in Venice. They rode around, tried to scout. Didn't see many birds down there in Venice. Same thing Ryan Lambert saying, it's slowest he's seen in a while. Another thing that would make Venice and Delacroix and all them, when we come in that second split, there's only about, because of the way the tides run, Ryan Lambert been saying for a year, there ain't but about 9 days, that whole month, that you'll have enough water to hunt. And when you're hunting down in that area, whether it's the Chaffalai or whatever, there's no water, no ducks. They're gonna go where they at least have some water. So you keep that in mind. Bobby Black and them, this has been the best year so far, and their breaks in Tensaw on their farm. They going back there, him and his nephew. The only time Bobby Black, he went with another friend and a pit blind, they didn't do that well. Not getting too many reports from Arkansas either. Now, they got them cold fronts, but I haven't no report from Arkansas from anybody. So if y'all got a report, send it to me. Some of them guys probably could use the work. If they killing ducks, y'all let me know. I ain't heard from Kobe either. I know Kobe and them have been killing speckle bellies, and he's always, that's a constant. He's probably going to start hunting. If he got an opening, you need to do one. You want to go hunt the breaks for the gadwall, because that is one of the best hunts I make every year. So when them gadwalls start going in them breaks, you call Top Gun and book your hunt. Catahoula, Brendan. Brendan Dubrock is our social media guy. Him and his sons and his friends have been killing a few birds in there. The water is almost at a perfect stage. They have to look and find. One day it is good, but they hadn't had a bad day. So that's the secret. Port Barry. My brother and them are hunting in Port Barry. Duke Landry, he hunts every chance he gets. Duke from Duke's Restaurant. Him and his dog Hank, they taking multiple people. They taking friends, nephews, whoever. And about 3 or 4 days a week. I think the worst trip they had was 12. Best one would be about 18. So he's killing a good duck. He's having fun. And when Duke comes, he brings food. He brings gumbo. He brings everything. So after the hunt, you can't beat being around Duke Landry. I had no word from Delacro. I haven't went back to my lease. I couldn't get in it. Probably by next week, when it opens back up, I'll have your report. I'll talk to the groups over there in Delacro. I'm talking about Mike Benz and all them, and I'll find out why and see what happened. I want to remind you again now, you want to stay abreast. They got changing the duck zones this coming year. So there's a bunch of ways you can. You can send a letter. You can address it to Larry Reynolds, the duck study leader over there at the Wildlife and Fisheries. You can go on their website. There's a bunch of ways you can just weigh in and just give your opinion about going back to two zones or the way they are right now, three. And deer hunting is my buddy, Cage Dubrock. That's Brendan's son. Went on the lease. He killed a spike buck. By the way, sometimes in these hunting clubs, they call these spikes. They don't want them breeding, I guess, because they're small. But he killed him. He made a good shot, and he got him up. Congratulations to him. I think that's all the ducks. When we come back, we got a tremendous, tremendous fishing report.
I'm Brett Favre. As a quarterback in the NFL, if I didn't stay focused, I ended up on my back or worse. Even the smallest distraction could make a good play or offensive drive come to an end. When you're in a car, the smallest distraction could end much more than a drive. It could end someone's life. Just like I refuse to lose on the field, I refuse to lose someone I love to distracted driving. And you should too. Focus on the road. Don't drive distracted. A message from Farm Bureau Insurance.
New Berkley Fireline Ultra 8. It's rounder, smoother, and 4 times more abrasion resistant than original Fireline. Expect 10% longer casts and superb knot strength.
And you thought Fireline couldn't get any better.
The best part about being a member of a Touchstone Energy Cooperative is that it's your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, to Berkley. Abu Garcia Fishing Report. And before I get started, by the way, you know, our sister, another show out to Bayou. Y'all have seen it a long time, but you know, Bayou Wild, that's our sister show, that's run, and that's produced by the Don Dubuque and Chris LeCocq. tremendous show, tremendous information. Him and Martha Spencer and them, they're doing a great job of covering the state. I just noticed in that duck hunting show they had with Mike, the world champion, Mike Smith down in the marsh. Now, Mike has been doing it for years, but he went through the way to call, what to call, blind calling. You know, he won the championships. They do all the hail calls and all the other calls you don't hear in a blind. But if you watch these regular hunters, when you go on a trip, when these guides, and you watch them, they do very little calling sometimes. But especially, they will not run a mallet call when there's gray ducks in the area. For some reason, I don't know. But they think it runs them away or whatever. They'll use their pintail whistle and all them. So when you just got through watching that, I want to tell you now. I'm going to go to a fishing report right now. Everything's on the up. The Golden Meadow Marsh, John Sherman fishing with Bruce Dodd. They had two limits of redfish. Every day they're going there and catching their limits of redfish. That's five a person, under 27 inches. All right. Ken Lambert and his brother, Harold, they have great days over there in Lake Catherine. Only one or two days they went out there and it was just too rough. They come back in and fish the Lakeshore Estates. They fished, they were catching catfish on trout bellies. They were catching big river cats, good eating cats. His grandson, Major, and Charlie, they come there every year. They fished the trussel. They fished in Lake Catherine. They catching the big sheephead. They catching everything. So them two boys right now, tremendous outdoorsmen. One of them's a wrestler. And when they go back to Alabama, he goes deer hunting. So now congratulations, but we just love when they get here. So we got the holidays coming up. Expect to see more and more of my grandkids and other grandkids in the woods during Christmas holidays. So a big fishing trip right now. When I talk about Lake Catherine, you know I'm always talking about Miss Angie and her husband David. They go fishing themselves, but right now, you know, they watch the tide, they watch the weather, being right there. They'll go out 2 or 3 or 4 hours, and they catching fish. Redfish is a constant, but the speckled trout are moving in, they catching beautiful. I heard there was fish coming from the rocks. Dudley Vanderboer and them will catch them on a slip cork and a Carolina rig. I get the drop shot has been the hottest one for the Lamberts and them, the people I know. All the captains over there fishing live shrimp. I got a report in from Seth Smith. He's taking a little vacation. He was been in Venice since Thursday or Friday, and he's fishing live shrimp, but he's been fishing Empire Canal the last couple of days, and before that was fishing Voodoo. But he says right now, live shrimp is a no miss, and he's still catching it. Ain't catching him as good as he was a few weeks ago downriver and everything. But right now, live shrimp, Empire Canal, you know what that is, right there by the harbor. So go to fishing down there. I'm going to come back before I go out. First, let me do a freshwater report. Freshwater report right now is the Chaffalai Spillway. Chaffalai Spillway, by Pigeon, by Saw. Jack Miller's has slowed down. There's a lot of boat traffic. I talked to Glenn Davis this morning, and Glenn said he had 45 beautiful sacalay in the Pigeon area, Catfish area, Grand Lake area. Wherever you've been catching fish, the water is clear. Now, last week, the boys found clear water, didn't find the fish. You know, now, the way that water is moving, you find that clear water, get off of them runouts or find that water mixing, shame on it. Them sacalay, they've been catching them on chartreuse and black, and they've been catching them on that, I forget that little color, but it's almost like a shad, okay? And it's the garner bait. See, I should have wrote it down. I keep getting tongue-tied again. Now, the bass, I've been hearing the bass coming from the marsh. I haven't heard any bass come from Venice right now, but go fishing. Delacro is still hot, tremendously hot. They're catching fish over there. They're catching bass in Delacro. Hopedale, Go to Atlantis, ask these people where they're fishing. They'll tell you. Tell you where to go fish in this lagoon or go in this bay. They are catching those fish right now. And all you do is watch the weather, watch the tide. Remember one thing, a west wind in Delacroix, you just soon stay at home, okay? If you want to know where to go, pick up the phone, call the marinas, call Jack. They'll tell you where to go. Let me think of something else right now. Fresh water, Toledo Bend. Now, if you get a north wind and everything gets rough, they catch them off those piers that go out. In deep water, they catch them. Call them guys over there. Check the lake country. Check their website and get some reports of fishing. I also got a report from Lake Concordia on Sakale. Now, I called some people from Lake Bruin because usually this time of year, they catch them on a yo-yo and they catch them Sakale and Lake Bruin. All my friends over there, I don't know whether they're hunting or not, but I'm not getting any reports. So all y'all people over there in central part of the state, holidays are coming. People want to go fishing. People want to go hunting. Please send me a report. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Get ready for Christmas next week. I'm going to have you some good Christmas ideas. And I'm going to tell you what, some of the best gifts you can give right now is a fishing trip. Call all the guides you know that I know. Call me. If you're looking for a trip, I put you on some guides, whatever area you want to be. Even a duck hunt, they're filling up fast, and second split going to be starting pretty soon. You're going to have about a month and a half left. So you call me, email me, and I'll give you a report. I'll give you a good guide you want to go in whichever area. You can go to they got a website for the captains and the guides. I forgot the name. What is that name of that thing, Chris? The captains. I forget the name of it. They got a website where they'll list all the captains. Good way, a fishing trip, great gift. Next week, I'm going to show you a little bit. It didn't come in. I got a boot jack, something great for the camp. JJ's boot jack, go on the internet, you'll see it. But next week, I'm going to show you. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Thank God for Louisiana. Get ready for Christmas. Here comes Santa Claus.
This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.